the morning, Quinn, who has the deepfake HOH, held one-on-one meetings, dressed up in a suit, and he got into character.
Ultimately, his plan for nominations is Mackenzie, Cedric, who volunteered, and Tucker, who's his target. Again, with the volunteers this season. Oh my gosh.
And I will not be banking off on the block. No, no, no. If I don't win, I'm not going to be banking off on the block. It better be someone I like. Who, story-wise, is great. You know, I don't know if that's... You guys are saying we don't care. And that's fine, it's fine. But... That's where I'm at.
You don't need to have meetings with people, bro. It's your decision. You're just doing this just to get in people's heads. You're not actual HOH. You're just trying to buddy up with everybody because I blew up all your shit now.
Yeah, I mean, that's true.
It's very obvious what he's trying to do. And I was trying to make it seem like he's got power so people will respect him when, yeah, bro, you can do it, but we still got veto. And you can't do anything over the veto. Angela gets to pick who goes back up.
No.
Yes, that's why he's just lying and telling everybody that. It's not true. That's two separate powers. You can't... Veto is the veto. You can never fuck with the veto. Only if you have a veto power upgrade.
You're saying replacement nom would not be...
Angela gets to pick the replacement.
Angela, being the regular HOH, held one-on-ones separately. She felt it silly holding formal one-on-ones, being that Quinn would just overthrow her nominations anyway. She did seem to think, though, that she had the power to renom, which even I'm not too sure about still.
That was all. It just was very... And then chemo came out.
Yeah.
And then it was just small talk again, nothing really game,
yeah.
And it was kind of done. And,
yeah.
And then Mackenzie came out, I said, I'm sorry about not having Morgan Wallen in here, and I know why I don't, because I told her down there before I came up here, and they took it out.
Mm-hmm.
So I just thought I could win a little favor with her if I did that, but I got screwed because I screwed myself by saying it downstairs.
Yeah.
Let's see. And then this
They're one, on to everything.
This is a little bit more pertinent.
Yeah.
Is Chelsea wanted to have a talk? And you're not somebody she's telling me she's going to have an alliance with at all or work with.
Mm-hmm.
You're not.
Yeah.
And when you won and when you did the things that you did, this is her, Brooklyn, and Vina's face looking at each other.
Yeah.
And rolling their eyes. And when you're doing something funny or when you're doing something, this is them rolling their eyes to each other. Looking at people's faces and reactions before I even try to have my own. And
yeah,
I'm telling you,
oh yeah,
those three are biggest thieves. And
I'm playing on right back,
but I'm feeling definitely that they don't stand a shot. Nobody in this house feels like they stand a shot with you.
I know that's where Cam was hearing it from. And that was like when he was the only person to tell me, and all the girls were extra reassuring that I would be okay. And
mm-mm.
That they always got my back. Uncle Tuck is what Brooklyn keeps calling me. And I think Cam's tight with them too. And Cam, they told him the real thing. And Cam let it slip up.
Or Leah told him.
And I was like, yeah. I was like, so who'd you hear it from? And then he said, like, Joseph and Takor. Which I'm like, those are probably the two people you didn't hear it from.
Because
you don't want to throw your alliance under Joseph and Takor. You and Joseph just shoot the shit. You guys aren't talking game. Joseph, I don't think he's talking game with anybody. He's just staying quiet and doing his thing like Takor.
And that'll get them very, very far by doing that.
Quinn and Tucker had a little heated conversation off camera. We heard Tucker call Quinn a lying piece of... Then Quinn immediately went into the back bedroom and had a little meltdown.
I would not do that.
I don't care. I don't believe you.
All right. Well, I'll show you in the veto ceremony.
Yeah.
I'll show you in the veto.
I'm going to win it, too.
Piss me off. Fucking dick.
Of shit.
Then I should do it, not you. Don't be ridiculous, Ruby, and I enjoy doing it.
Chili?
Chili oil and everything. Makes everything better.
Mm-hmm.
You want to try it?
Come on.
You like a little bit of spice.
Why would I trust that we would actually literally squash it when I have a nuclear weapon duct taped to my chest? Why would I believe that? That is so...
Okay.
Watch the show.
Put that on anything.
Watch the show.
Do you eat egg? Mm-hmm.
If you're going to do this, watch it. It's not hard.
Oh, I eat eggs.
Okay. I'd argue, bare minimum. That's crazy.
Apparently, Quinn is upset that Tucker's going around telling everyone that he's lying about his power. Meanwhile, Robina did get a little upset with Tucker about this. She's not liking the way he's been acting.
Okay. I wish Rubina wasn't so pissed.
She's working on it.
I'll talk to her later.
I think that, like, if you wanted to, I would articulate that, like, hey, it, like...
It's just fun and games.
Yeah, yeah, if I articulate, like, hey, it doesn't bother me. Like, whenever I got called up, and I was like, I'm not scared.
Yeah, that's how
and
you gotta be.
We got in there, balls started flying, I was like, all right. I'm scared.
And were you mad when I was like, fine, I already beat you two guys in a...
Nah, it's all a game, bro.
It's all part
it's
of
all
the game.
It's all a game. Yeah, I know what's up.
I don't know why she got so pissed, bro.
Oh, she was upset?
Yeah, bro, we're just playing a game.
Some people do they build like that.
When I'm in it, though. Like,
you know what I mean?
She's not even up there. Yeah. Chill out. We'll be fine.
Yeah. You gotta remember, though. See, I almost called you that. You gotta remember, Tucker, that some people aren't built like us, though. Like,
yeah.
But no worries, Tubina fans. They did make up later in the night. Speaking of Rubina, she retold the heated moment between her and Tucker to T-Core and Chemo.
Nothing happened.
This is the him of you.
Him?
This is you.
T-Core, you can chill. You can chill, bitch. You can take it. You're out of 10 and I need you at like a 5. But he pulled me in, I don't...
Yeah.
That's okay. Then it got close over. Nothing happened here. But it was on the way. Nothing. It's not like...
Actually, not bad for me.
Yeah. Anyway, I'm doing good because I am pulling back when it's close.
It took an extra long time for the feeds to cut for the ceremony, and I think that's because they basically broke the power. This was supposed to be some huge shock and awe type of twist, and now they all know about it. Production definitely had to retweak some things. So everyone was still really confused about the power and what Angela was still allowed to do and not do. But when they eventually did cut out and come back, we had nominations. Quinn had nominated Cedric, Mackenzie, and Tucker as planned, and apparently this nomination ceremony only took 40 minutes. Late in the night, we had conversations about veto picks, and Mackenzie did some campaigning because she does not feel safe on that block. As always, if you're liking these videos, make sure to like and subscribe, follow me in all my socials, because you know I'm covering...
Big Brother!